So we're awaiting the 2020 graduation, and they're expecting about 50 graduates to return for this evening.
Good evening, graduates, faculty, staff, students, parents, family, and friends. I'm Mr. Brockway. I'm the principal here at Vasquez High School. A special welcome to our governing board members, President Kelly Jensen, Vice President Tim Jurgensen, Clerk Chad Wadsworth, and Ken Falsgraf. Our district administration, including Superintendent Larry King, Assistant Superintendents Kim Shaw and Hassan Mirza. Welcome one and all to the commencement ceremony honoring Vasquez High School's graduating class of 2020. A few reminders, restrooms are located in the back. There's hand wash stations next to them, as well as hand sanitizing stations. We ask that you keep masks on during the ceremony. Please help us safely and smoothly celebrate our graduates. Pardon me just one second. We were supposed to have the mounted sheriff's department here tonight. Unfortunately, they were not able to make it. But if you could all please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Next, we'd like to play the national anthem, so please stay standing. Be seated. Next, I'd like to take a moment of silence for Station 81. Thank you. Please welcome our immediate past board president, Ken Falsgraf, to the podium.
Good evening, everyone. Little preface here. A couple years ago, the school board took up the practice of rotating the presidency each year so there would be equity in how we service our public and be able to exercise our skills or lack of to contribute to the board in the school district. 2019 and 2020 was my presidential year, and if you are the school board president, despite all the politics and everything we do sitting up there each night, the grand finale and what this is really all about is to see your seniors cross the stage and get their diplomas. And in March 2020, I was robbed of that. I'm going to keep it together. I've got a tough guy image to keep up. I was robbed of that opportunity. March is not my favorite month to begin with. I want to go back to March 1986. Life was what it always was for me. I was floating along about 26 years old or just thereabouts. I didn't pay much attention to what was going on around me. Work had begun a little, had been getting a little slow. I drove into the yard of Bill Jackson Rig Company in Elk City, Oklahoma one morning, only to find that the company was going to be closed. We were going to be without a job. And the only thing I knew how to do effectively, my career was disappearing right in front of my eyes. I knew right then I need to get out of that town and I need to get out of that state. Everything about my identity, everything about my livelihood was taken away from me in a second. My life would change forever and dramatically, and none of it had anything to do with anything I could control. What does this have to do with you guys? Everything. Let's fast forward to March 2020. Some of you are skating along because you're academically gifted. You're just waiting for the day till you can finally shake our hands and go out into the real world as adults. Others, if they were like me when I was a student, were struggling, wondering if they were going to pass that one class that would get them their diploma. And then regardless of who you were, what you were doing or not doing, the world decided to dump on you overnight and take everything that you had coming away from you. I look back now, and what I was experiencing in 1986 is nothing compared to what you, the class of 2020, was experiencing. I could run off to somewhere else. You had nowhere to go because everyone in this whole world was experiencing simultaneously what you were experiencing. None of you had any control over it. So let's jump to the end of my story. About 3 weeks later, I was in Las Vegas, Nevada, running a crane with making more money than I ever had. 16 years after that, I found myself in California. And 20 years after that, or about 2 weeks ago, I began my 21st year of service with a fine municipality in the Southern California area. Moral of the story there is on three different occasions in my life, I have had to dramatically change my career and what I do. Be prepared to do that. There's relevance in everything you do today for what it means tomorrow. But this didn't happen to me because I was lucky. These difficulties taught me resilience. And most importantly, outside of me, at each point in my life, I can look back and see there was one person who saw nothing but resilience in me when I had absolutely nothing else to offer and believed in me and opened a door for me that changed my life. Back to you all, you are still here, believe it or not. Grab, pinch yourself, you're still here. The world didn't get you. The doors of life are going to fling open for you very soon. There's going to be opportunities abound. And some old dude like me is going to sit at a table and ask you goofy questions like, what's your five-year plan? What's the other one? Oh, what makes you different? I love that one. You guys smile inside and think to yourself, I have resilience. I'm the class of 2020. I went through everything. When the whole world stacks up against me, I'm there at the end of the day. And when everything shuts down, I start up. And believe that about yourself. You may not understand it now, but someday you will. There's something I want to share with you. If there's the biggest regret in my life, I have not been able to go back and apologize to the teachers who I made their life a living nightmare trying to find my identity and who I was being a clown in the class. I can never go back and fix it and apologize to those people. But I want you to realize everything you've experienced in the last year, there are people around you that have been supporting you, not only during the past year, but during your entire life going back to when you were a crying little kid going in the door of kindergarten, leaving your parents at the staff. They have been there for you the entire time. And guess what? Their world was collapsing simultaneously as yours was. And some of them, including our teachers, their life was changing monthly, weekly, and even daily, and things were being thrown at them in your interest to try to get you back in the school, and they were too big to let you know that they had some suffering going on inside because they didn't want to put any more pressure on you than you were already having. So do a favor for me. I want you to take a minute. I want you to think about and identify those people that made a difference in your life this year and in the past. They're opening doors for you and encouraging to find out who you are, what your potential is, and ultimately what your success in life will be. You would not be resilient. You would not be anything without these people except a lonely person wondering what to do. When you find them, look in their eyes and thank them for what they've done. Be specific. You know what they've done. Don't be shy. Start right now by looking around you and see who's sitting next to you. They have done something for you that no one else can do. And then when you're done and you walk up here at the end, these people have made your life. Don't forget that. These people right here. Do not let this opportunity pass you by. I'm going to tell you three names that are significant to me, that have opened doors for me when no one else could, not even me. That's Nolan Stampa, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Most recently, Fred Wilecki, Malibu, California. And finally, most importantly, a person who's never spoken a word in her life and has the most profound impact on me as an individual, and that is my daughter, Tammy Falsgraf. I've been waiting to tell this story for a long time, but nobody would understand what I'm talking about. And if there was one group of people that could relate specifically to what I'm talking about tonight, it is you and only you. On behalf of my colleagues on the school board, we give you fine volunteer service and have nothing but the best interest for you in mind. We could not be more proud of this class, the class of 2020.
Last year was my first year as principal. It was an amazing year starting out with your seniors, each of them extremely respectful, responsible, and now we know that they were extremely resilient. I had 7 months with your students. Many of them I knew by name. I was excited this morning when we had practice and I could picture who each of these students were. I was excited that so many decided to come back. Out of the 82 graduates from last year, we had 42 indicate that they would come back. It was honestly much more than I expected. I want to thank the parents for pushing their students and their graduates to always strive better, to see the silver lining in everything that had occurred last year. Thank you for pushing me as an administrator to ensure that I never forgot to honor your students, your children, your graduating class of 2020. I'm a man of little words. I don't like being the center of attention, and we're all here to celebrate the graduates. So without further ado, I would like to honor the Vasquez High School Senior Honor Scholars. These honor scholars are the most academically decorated students, those who have achieved a cumulative weighted academic GPA of 3.75 or higher through their high school career. Seniors that maintain this distinction are identified with gold robes and the title of Honor Scholar. Class of 2020 Honor Scholars, if you please stand as I call your name, I would appreciate it. Allison Aceves. Casey Aguilas. David Fox. Caroline Fox. Jackson Kessler, Ben Lee, Marilyn Medina. Jacob Orl. Clara Swanson. Demi Trepanier. Jolene Wessel. And Israel Zaragoza. Thank you, and please take your seats. Next, I'd like to welcome our valedictorian from last year, who finished her high school career at the top of her class with a 4.52 cumulative weighted academic GPA. Please welcome to the stage, Casey Arguelles.
Speeches are pretty long and talk about how we're leaving high school and starting on a new beginning. But in our case, most of us have already gotten jobs, started college, and have begun on whatever path we've chosen for ourselves. So instead, I want to reflect back on what we have overcome. It was devastating to lose out on those last few months together, and the pandemic didn't help when we were all separated from our family, friends, and everything else that made our life normal. But one thing that I learned through this whole experience is that you have to appreciate life for everything it gives you. You can't take it for granted because it's always changing. In the blink of an eye, it can change, and you have a pandemic that has you locked down. But we will always persevere and always make it. You'll never know when you can take for granted the simplest moments of seeing your friends, family, traveling, buying toilet paper at the grocery store, you know. And now that we've made it here, when all of us had given up hope of saying goodbye to our teachers and school friends, I want to remind you to stay strong, never give up, and always remember, nothing lasts forever, even the bad days. Thank you.
Thank you, Casey. It is now time for our Board of Trustees to confer diplomas to our graduates on stage. Student names will be read by Mr. Anthony Salcedo. Before we get started with that, I wanted to go over some ground rules for the graduates and their parents. You'll notice that you're sitting with your graduates. This was intentional so that you can escort them, if you choose, up to the stage. When they first come up, they'll stop right about here. They'll get the diploma cover with me. You can take a picture by standing right here. Then they'll walk across the stage, shaking the hands of all of our guests on stage. They'll stop here. And William Edwards will be taking a professional photograph of them. Then they will finish by walking by the teachers. As that happens, you can cross the front here and return with your seniors and your graduates over on that side of the field. Without further ado, Mr. Salcedo.
Row one, please stand. Allison Aceves. Yeah. William Alford.
Alba Vialta. Anthony Alvarado. Abigail Andre. Jessica Bowman. Jacqueline Beltran. Marco Benitez. Abby Bloom. Brady Chicado. Riley Colfer. Austin Corey. Ulysses Diaz Barriga Serrano. Dylan Dole. David Fox. Caroline Fox. Rochelle French. Mitch Gersh. Jackson Kessler. Mason Klein. Ben Lee. Luis Lopez. Cora Machado. Mark Manzanares. Isaiah Martinez. Braulio Mata. Rafferty Mattson. Serena McFarlane. Noah Knowles. Sophie Nyland. Jacob Obney. Jacob Oral. Michael Palayo. Arturo Portillo. Edward Romano Jr. Jacqueline Roosh. Megan Rudd. Blake Shefty. Joshua Stevenson. Taylor Torkelson. Hunter Weir. Blake Welch. And Jolene Wessel. Mr. King and the Board of Trustees, I can finally and formally present the class of 2020 to you and certify that they have completed all of the requirements for graduation from Vasquez according to board policy, California Education Code, and federal law. You guys can applaud for that. Please welcome Superintendent Larry King to the stage for some final words and the acceptance of the class of 2020.
Thank you, Mr. Brockway. Good evening. First of all, I want to say that I'm very proud that this is my last official work for the district, and I couldn't be more proud of this class for everything that you've gone through to get here. And I'm just very excited that this is the piece that I get to leave with. I'd also like to recognize for a moment, as Mr. Falsgraf came up here as the president from last year on the board, Mr. Brandon Roquet has gracious us with his presence tonight, also being on the board last year and was part of this class as part of the governing board. Thank you for being here, Mr. Roquet. Lower the glasses. Okay. I'm going to keep my comments brief as well because the time I spent getting to know you pales in comparison to what your peer shared with you, which was remarkable. I appreciate her words very much. Some of you have known each other for an awful long time and have grown up together, and that's unique to hear. Even as you look around the hills and the little valley you sit in here, this is a very unique experience and opportunity. I've been at large districts, two of them, and I've been at one other small district at Lake Arrowhead, and it's always amazing to see the difference between a small district and a tight-knit community and a graduation like this. I want to congratulate you on this major accomplishment, milestone in your life. You've demonstrated commitment, dedication, perseverance, and all of that leads to what we've talked about. Perhaps you've heard from your teachers or your principal or me talk about growth mindset, and you've all exhibited that, as you can see as your evidence being here tonight. I want to thank some of you have brothers and sisters with you here tonight, or maybe aunts and uncles, parents, grandparents. I want to thank those loved ones that are here supporting you. Can we give them a big hand, please? And I'd like to thank those people who played a big role in helping you get here, and that's your teachers. Can we give a big hand for our teachers, please? And finally, I'll just conclude by saying thank you for allowing me to be part of this great evening and part of your education, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. With that, graduates, please stand. Graduates, you may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, class of 2020.
With that, that concludes the graduation ceremony. Thank you for being a part of the Vasquez family and coming out tonight. We truly appreciate it. You all have a great night, a great weekend, and a great summer.